Hello, I'm at Starbucks. They don't take EBT here, so I had to go buy my Starbucks across the street and bring it over here. See, I got that. Well, they gave me the water, but I had to buy that at the Circle K because they don't accept EBT here. Anyway, I just walked around all day taking care of things. My battery's dead on my car, so I can't drive it. But I've got some extra long cable that I was using to tie stuff down. It's real heavy duty, and I've used that kind of cable before to charge batteries. So I'm gonna make some extra long homemade cables to charge my battery enough to get it started. Once I get it started, then the alternator will take over and charge it. I'll just drive it. So that'll be good. Anyway, I've walked probably, 8-10 miles today. And I went over to Solano County Health, and I got the paperwork to get switched over from Tehama County to here, so I can get a doctor here, and so I can go to the dentist and stuff like that. And they said, well, you gotta have an address. So I went, I walked over to Peabody Road to the post office to find out that I didn't have to do that. But I did it anyway, so I changed my address to General Delivery, Vacaville. And then I went back over the other side of the Highway 80 to Solano County thing again, and I filled out the paperwork and I turned it in. And the lady tried to blame me. Well, I called, you took off. I said, well, I want to go talk to the Obama phone people out front. Apparently, it's going to take a month to get my Obama phone replaced. And she says, well, the computers are down in Red Bluff, so they couldn't help me. Or you weren't here, and you couldn't answer the questions. They wanted to know where your address is. And I said, well, I don't have an address. I said, I've got a California driver's license, and it's got an address on it, but I don't live there anymore, and the people don't want to talk to me. They're all Jehovah's Witnesses. I didn't tell them that, but that's the case. So, they're not going to be taking mail for me there. So I'm being rude and eating, sorry. So I got General Delivery. I switched my address to General Delivery. I get it that for a month, and then after that I got to figure out something, because then they'll quit. They said you get a month to get your life together. Thanks, federal government. Appreciate that. So I went and I stopped at a bunch of places and asked them, for work. And nothing panned out. So I think I'll probably just have to do something on my own. I'm going to try to get a job at Walmart. I think what I want to do is pull orders for, curbside pickup. I just want to pull orders. Just walk around the store and fill in the baskets and then go turn it into those guys, and they make sure that the person gets it. Excuse me, I got chills. Anyway, I think that would be good. An easy job, I can do that. There's not a lot of lifting and bending and all that. And I don't want to try to do something real physical. I could do it, but it just saps my energy, And it's not going to help me. If I get a job working super hard, I won't be able to keep that job. I won't be able to last at it. So I need to get something easy to do like that. So hopefully they'll hire me for that. And if I could get that kind of job in an all-night Walmart, which they don't have here, but maybe pull orders in the middle of the night, I guess that's a thing. I don't know. Anyway. I do have... I got a couple bucks, like $6. And I need to buy a dollar store pair of of reading glasses, because these are... Oh, man. These are not... I'm being vain. actually, I don't even know what, I can't tell what they are. Yeah, I can't even read what it is. I don't think they're the right prescription anyway, or the right, oh, cute puppy. Everybody's freaking out about their cat, their dog. I wonder if they'd freak out if I brought my cat in here. Anyway. So, I got all that done. I got the paperwork filled in. All that. And they said it's going to take a month. I said, I'll be dead by then. Well, we don't know what to do. Can't do nothing about it. It's up to them. Blah, blah, blah. And I just thought, whatever. So, if I got to go to the doctor, I have to go to the emergency room. I can't have a, because it's for a different county. That's how screwed up this system is. Because it's for a different county, I can't go get a doctor right now. I can't go to the dentist. I can't do anything until they switch it to this county. That's so stupid. Whatever. Anyway, I'm not going to worry about it. I'm done. I got it all done. I've done everything I can. I don't. They want a phone number so they can text me. I don't even have a freaking phone. And I tried to get the Obama phone, and she said it's going to be hell on earth. So I just need to get a job, and I need to get my iPhone that I'm using right now. Verizon told me how to get this phone unlocked, and I'm going to do it. I mean, he told me what to do. And I recorded it, and I'm going to do it. So anyway, I'm working on that. Pretty soon I will have this phone unlocked, and I will have it under a different carrier, and it will be a pay-as-you-go thing, and I'll just get the cheapest and fastest one I can find. And there's lots of them out there right now, so pretty soon I will have it all taken care of. Also, I found a little Toyota camper, like a Sun Raider or a Sunseeker. It's a, 83, I think. I've been looking for one. I found one. And she wants to sell it. It's only got 36,000 miles on it, or 31,000. But it's rough. I mean, it's been sitting outside. She didn't keep it garaged, so it's got a lot of issues. But I can fix all of it. I know how to fix all of it. I've done several of them so far, so, and I'm going to make it an off-grid thing. It's not going to have black water tanks. It's going to have a composting toilet. It's going to have a instant hot water heater for taking showers. It is going to have a tank for gray water and pee. That's okay. But it will have a composting toilet. I'm going to build one this time, not spend $1,000 like I did last time. Forget that. And this thing is going to be off grid, and it's got the motor in it is an R22R, very popular motor, and it's got such low miles. I'm thinking I could sell that motor for $1,000 and pay to offset the cost of the thing, and then I'm going to put it a five-cylinder diesel in it out of a Mercedes, because that's the thing you do to old Toyotas if you want a diesel. Somebody makes a kit so we can bolt it right up. It's awesome. And this one's got a five-speed, I think it's a five-speed or a four-speed manual. So I'll have a diesel five-speed little oil burner. It'll run on anything. It'll run on French fry oil. It'll run on, I could pull up to a farm and drain the engine oil out of a tractor that they don't use anymore and cut it with a little bit of gasoline and put it in the tank and drive the thing. Literally. So they'll run on anything. And these motors last like 1,000,000 miles. So it's one of the best motors ever made. Is the, I can't remember what they call it, the, like an 85 Mercedes 300T, 300 turbo diesel. That would be the ultimate one. Actually, the ultimate one would be the AMG diesel, because they are they're even more high performance, but you probably won't be able to find one of those. Or even, it doesn't even have to be turbo. It could just be a regular aspirated one. But I want to get the turbo diesel, I think. And I've already checked on Pick Apart. They're all over the place. And you can get a turbo diesel motor long block from Pick Apart for like $500. It's a no-brainer. So that's what I want to do. And it's looking like things are looking up. I found my wallet. It was in the car, so I didn't lose that. Which means I got my ID and I got my EBT card. So I've been using that. I got plenty of money on the EBT card, so I got food to eat. I just don't have any money. But I'm trying to get work, a little bit of work. I actually went door to door asking if I could do anything over the weekend, you know, just honey-do list, anything that, and I talked to a couple people, and I don't know, that neighborhood wasn't very friendly, so I shook the dust off my feet, and I went to the school behind them, and I sat down, and read the Bible, and I worked out. And what I've been doing is, when I'm doing all this walking, there's tons of intersections. When I get to an intersection, I push the button, and I have to wait, you know, for my turn to go. And I time it so that I do my breathing, and when I get to the button, I push the button, figure out how much time I have. Usually it's about a minute and a half, and I just drop down, and I start doing push-ups. It's a game I play. It's like, I can't cross the street until I do at least 10 push-ups. And sometimes I do 10, sometimes I do 30. Sometimes I do 3, because it's that quick that it changes. But I do that all day long. And, you know, I'm walking like 8, 10 miles. So I get in like 100 push-ups a day now, which is pretty awesome. And when I started this, when did I start this? Before I went to jail. Because I remember I was doing some push-ups in the jail, and the guard was like, nope, nope, because he said I wasn't doing them right. And he was looking through the window, he was just harassing me. And I looked up at him, and I said, what? And he says, you're not doing them right. And I said, fuck you, asshole. He didn't like that. That's when he had me come out and sign the paper, but he wouldn't let me, and then he threw me back in. He was playing mind games with me because I told him, fuck off. But you know what? I got freedom of speech. And I know my rights. And you know what? If I have to become an auditor, First Amendment auditor, I will. I'll just have to bone up on my rights and make sure I always got my camera on. You know, I've watched some of those videos, Audit the Auditor or whatever it's called. Those guys don't play around, man. They get results. I don't want to have to do that shit, but looks like I'm going to have to do something here, because this town has gone to hell, that's for sure. Anyway, trying to train my beard to look all stylish and dapper. It's just not getting, you know, it's not long enough yet, but I'm trying to get it to look better. My neckline is all jacked. It needs to get fixed. I'll worry about that later. I don't really care. I don't have any hair anyway, so I want to shave my head completely. I want to just go polish that bitch. It's going to have some scars here from my fall, but that's okay. You know, I can't feel them as much as I used to. I used to couldn't even comb my hair because it had stitches in there and it would grab them. But I don't even feel where the scars are anymore. They used to be ridges. I had like ridge scars, but I don't even feel them. So maybe it won't be that bad. Anyway, things are going good. Kitty's safe. It's not too hot right now. It's been really cool. And he's parked in the shade. And I keep checking on him. He's fine. He's got plenty of food to eat. Good food, you know. I just go to Walmart and get him canned chicken and canned tuna. He loves it. Spoiled little cat. He loves me. He just cuddles with me all night. Just, it's awesome. We're soulmates. So, I don't care. I mean, I do care that I got all my stuff taken. I still haven't given up on the thought that maybe the cops actually have it. They just don't know their ass from a hole in the ground. And, you know, maybe it'll turn up one of these days. Or maybe it'll just be stuck in wherever they keep evidence or whatever. And 5 years later, maybe they'll auction it all off or something. I don't know. I can't worry about it. I can't lose any sleep over it. It's gone. You know, and Jesus said that you have to lose everything. You have to lose everything to inherit the kingdom. And you know what? Now I've actually lost everything. The only thing I have is my car and my cat. That's all I got left. Everything got taken. It's gone. And it sucks, but I can't do anything about it. I already cried about it, you know? So what can I do? I don't know. Matthew, I want to try to find that scripture. Matthew 29, I think it was. I think I wrote it down. I was trying to find the scripture. I don't know where it is. I'm sorry. I looked it up earlier. I just can't remember where it was. I think it's Matthew 26. Anyway, it's where Jesus says that, you know, people who've lost families and they've lost homes and they've lost this and they lost that on account of the kingdom, they'll be rewarded 100-fold for their faithfulness. You know, and I have lost a lot. And, you know, the naysayers and the Bork people, they're all going to say, oh, you deserve that because you went apostate. Well, fuck off. All of you. You should fuck yourself. You don't know what the hell you're talking about. But that's okay. You know. Oh, and excuse my French. You know. Yeah, you're right. Jesus' blood isn't thick enough and strong enough and powerful enough to cover my potty mouth. So, I'm in big trouble. No, if that's the case, we're all in big trouble. You know what? What can I say? So anyway, some major things are brewing. I'm not even going to tell you what I did today. I didn't do anything wrong, but it was pretty amazing. And I can't put it on Facebook because people that watch my video, I know people are watching my video. I don't want them to know what it is, not until after the fact. So, anyway, it's pretty cool. It's really cool. So, things are doing better, you know. My coat that I bought at JCPenney and all that, I got enough gas money. Somebody gave me $10. I think I told that story where I was talking to somebody in the Walmart bathroom and somebody was sitting on the toilet. I needed to use the toilet, but he was in there and I was walking out and he goes, hey, I threw you some money. I go, are you talking to me? And he goes, yeah, I threw you some money. I said, huh? He goes, and I see this money rolled up, just fly out of this stall. And I'm like, hey, here's some money here. And he goes, yeah, that's for you. It was 10 bucks. I'm like, you gave me 10 bucks? And he goes, yeah. I said, thank you. So I went and put that money in the tank, and I drove to Fairfield. I took that jacket back, and I got my money back for that. I got it put on my debit card that the jail gave me. So then I went and got my cat. I'm flush with money, right? I got like $43, $44. So I got enough gas in the car. I got 100 miles of gas in the car right now, but a dead battery, which is okay because I've been walking a lot and getting exercise. So, you know, it's working out. And like I said, I've been doing all these push-ups now. I never could do, I could do like 2 push-ups before. Now I can bust out push-ups left and right, and I can feel I'm getting stronger, and hopefully I'll be losing these man boobs, you know? And I have to change my diet because I've been getting fat. I've been gaining weight. I've been checking my weight every day, and my blood pressure is good because I'm on the blood pressure medicine, but my weight is going up. I lost weight in the hospital, but I've been eating, you know, just stupid stuff, I guess. Not sugar, but like sandwiches and stuff like that, and lots of carbs. So I'm gonna have to go back to the low carb, lots of meat, and I'm probably gonna get off coffee and just do like the shaga mushroom drink and all that, cordyceps and lion's mane mushroom drink for energy and for brain power. And I think EBT pays for all that stuff. I could probably eat pretty good with EBT if I, you know, figure out a way to cook some steak, which will be next. I'm gonna figure out that. Which I can do that. It's just kind of hard in a car. And I don't have any money to buy it, the right thing, but that's okay. I'm really focused on that. I want to get the money to buy that trailer, that little camper thing. It runs, so I could go get it and take it off her property. She's got a title for it, $1,000. It's insane. Those things are worth money. You know, I could probably have a business restoring those things and converting them to diesel and get big bucks. Because when I get done with this one, it's going to be worth like 50 or 60 grand. Literally. Because it's going to be off-grid, and it is going to be set up for when the shit hits the fan. And gas is like 12 bucks a gallon, and diesel is even more. I won't need diesel. It'll run on French fry oil. It'll run on anything. Like I said, old tractor oil, just cut it a little bit with some diesel or gasoline, and people do that all the time. Might not run, might not last 100,000 miles or 1 million miles, but I don't care. And it's gonna have a lot of torque. I just wish it was four-wheel drive. That would be awesome. And I have seen some four-wheel drive camper Toyota ones. That would be the ultimate. Four-wheel drive, five-cylinder turbo diesel Toyota camper. That would be like 90 grand right there. Especially if you restored it nice. So anyway, that's something to think about. I don't know. I also want to make a diesel motorcycle. Just like a two-cylinder diesel, like you would find on a generator or something. People make motorcycle engines that, you know, they get a regular motorcycle and they slap that in there, and now they got a biodiesel motorbike, which will get like 150 miles a gallon. So when the shit hits the fan, that would be something that would run on French fry oil. I'm just thinking about the future because I don't see how this is gonna keep going the way they want it to go. I think one of these days, we're going to end up being like it was in the 1840s before the Industrial Revolution, you know, and we'll be fortunate to be able to use a telegraph. But I think all this crap, all this technology is going to bite the dust. Some bad actor, maybe not worldwide, but it could happen like half of a state or maybe half of the country. If somebody fires off one of these neutrino bombs that are out there, that's what they're designed to do, is create a huge EMF. Oh shit, oh dear, if that happens, we're screwed. And, you know, what if they did it in New York? We're screwed. Or what if they did it on the West Coast? We're screwed. And it's a real threat. It's not aliens or it's not anything like that. It's neutrino bombs. That's what they do. And they're out there. They've been out there. Whatever. I'm just preparing for the worst. And that's how I want to live anyway. Even if it never happens and we end up, you know, having Facebook and all this crap forever, I don't want to be part of it. I want to live off grid. If I even live long enough, you know, I'd love to be able to live to be 85 or 90 years old and live off grid. That's why I'm trying to get in shape and, you know, work out and stuff like that and do the cold water dips and do the breathing that I've been doing. It works. That's why I'm doing it. Not because I'm crazy, because it freaking works. You know? I went from being able to do only like 2 push-ups a couple weeks ago to now I can bust out 100 push-ups. I don't think I can do them all at once, though. But during the day, I mean, I can do 30 or 40 in one shot, which is pretty good for me. So I'm happy about that. And I talked to the Solano County guy today, and I said, hey, I want to ask you a question about, you know, jumping in the canal out in the country. And he said it would be okay out there because they don't protect, that's not protected. But the one he was at where I talked to him, definitely, that's all posted and that's like federal. You don't mess around with that. But he said way out in the boonies where I was, he said, yeah, that's, they don't care. So I'm gonna keep doing my cold water immersion out there. And, you know, I'll be respectful. I'm not going to just be jumping in and out when people are watching. I'll be careful and do it like I did it the other day. So, anyway, I've been talking for 28 minutes. That's a good amount of time. Am I not Shane, your brother? I hope I am.